In a development environment, the run server command is used to serve the Django app in the local browser. That is because there is a basic server built into Django that is able to serve the app locally on port 8000 by default, unless another IP and port are specified. In a development environment, using run server is good enough, and it has useful features such as auto-restarting when a file is edited and saved, as well as serving the static files on the file system. However, in production or staging, something more robust and secure is needed. WSGI, or Web Server Gateway Interface, describes a group of web servers that are able to act as an interface between a Python application and a web server. Gunicorn is an example of a WSGI server, and Nginx is an example of a web server. So when a web server receives a HTTP request, the request can have a static port requesting static data such as images, CSS, or JavaScript files, and a dynamic port requiring Python code interpretation. The web server is able to deal with the static port, thus taking that load off. The dynamic Python part is forwarded to the WSGI server, which is able to interact with the Python application. The WSGI server processes the request and sends a response back to the web server, which forwards it to the client. But how is a WSGI server different from the development server, which is built into Django? A WSGI server, such as Gunicorn, is able to spawn several workers at a time, and those are parallel processes that can handle incoming requests. It has a proper logging feature, it's fast, and has built-in security measures. It is ideally used as part of the production or staging environment for a Django web app. A WSGI server, such as Gunicorn, is not able to automatically serve static files like the development server does, which is a reason why a web server such as Nginx is needed. Nginx is a reverse proxy server that accepts requests from the client and then decides where to delegate them. So let's see how we can serve a Django project using Gunicorn and Nginx. Here I'm on my Ubuntu machine, and the first thing I'll do is install Nginx using apt. And then after that, I'm going to install the virtual environment module for Python. I'm also going to use apt for that. So and then I will create an environment for Django. So I'm going to use env. I'm gonna call it Django env. And here you can see the folder over here. So I'm going to source or activate my virtual env. And now that's activated, I'm going to install Django. I'm also going to install Gunicorn. And I will then start my Python project using Django admin start project, and I'm going to call it my project. And here you can see my project over here. So the first thing I'll do is I'm just going to copy my IP address and then add it to the settings file of my project. I'm going to scroll to allowed hosts and just add it over here. And after that, I will start writing the configuration for Gunicorn, and I'm just going to create a conf directory here and create a file called gunicornconfig.py, And then there, I will just copy this and paste it over here. And this config has or just specifies the executable of Gunicorn. It then specifies the path for my project and where Gunicorn is listening. So it's listening on my IP address at port 8000, and it's going to be using 3 workers. Now I'm going to save this, and I'm going to start Gunicorn using this command, Gunicorn command, and then I'm going to use the configuration file I created just now, and I will specify the WSGI file in my project so Gunicorn can already see my project, because I specified that in my conf, and I'm just gonna point it to the WSGI.py file. And after that, I'm just gonna press enter, and here you see it started with the workers, and I'm going to have this play out in the background, and for that I'm just gonna press Control Z, and then I'm gonna say BG for background. So the next thing I'll do is I will start Nginx, and I'm just gonna say, well, for this part you don't have to be in your virtual environment, Nginx is outside of it. I'm just gonna say Nginx start. I will then make a static directory in here, and in this directory I'm going to, or I'm just going to point to this directory, so it's in home Ubuntu. I'm going to edit my project again, the settings file, and I will go to the static folder over here, and then just say it's in home Ubuntu static, and then save this. And after that, I'm going to edit the, or create a config file for my project for Nginx, and I'm going to create it in sites available directory, and in there I'm going to create a file called my project. And in my project, I'm going to add the configuration for my project over here. So Nginx is going to listen at port 80. This is the IP address of my machine. It's going to be listening on port 80 for this IP address, and I'm just specifying the static folder because the Nginx, as we said, is going to deal with the static files. I'm specifying the location over here, and then here I'm just going to, it's proxying with Gunicorn, which as we said is running on port 8000. Now this is a very simple configuration file. You can obviously add more stuff, for example certificates and other things, but this is a very minimal one. I'm going to save it, and after that I'm going to cd into sites enabled, and obviously I want to enable my site, and to do that I'm just gonna create a link to my project like this. And here you can see the link over here for my project. And after that, I will just restart Nginx using systemctl start Nginx. And now that it's restarted, I'm just going to copy my IP address and go to the browser and see if we get anything. And here you can see if I enter my IP address, it's by default listening up port 80 is my Django project. Now I hope this was useful for you, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments below.